LPR cameras in the Illustra IQ Pro series offer edge-based license plate recognition, perfect for low to moderate speed environments, such as managing vehicle-based access, monitoring parking activity, commercial and industrial loading areas, curbside pickups, drive-throughs, or school drop-off and pickup areas. This edge-based solution provides cost-effective scalability. Pro Series Illustra IQ cameras are also eligible for free exacqVision licensing. A separate video and support article provide guidance on claiming your free licensing for Illustra IQ cameras. This video will provide valuable information on installation best practices to achieve optimal results from these camera models, as well as their use with your exacqVision software. The Bullet comes with a mounting arm for wall installation or use with corner and pole mounting plates sold separately. A threaded 1.5-inch NPT pipe adapter is also packaged for additional installation flexibility. The dome may be attached to a separately sold wall mount or pendant cap. See the Illustra Accessories Guide for further details. Prior to installation, consider the environment, as you may need to make accommodations for reliable operation. To get the best performance from your Illustra IQ LPR-enabled cameras, adhere to the following guidelines. Once mounted, adjust the field of view so that it is 6 to 8 feet wide at the point of interest. The vehicle should take up most of the camera's field of view at the point you expect to detect the plate. LPR works best with a camera configured for this task. If you require a more general overview of the area, we recommend installing a second non-LPR camera for this purpose. The camera should be located 15 to 50 feet from the desired vehicle location. The camera should be no more than 30 degrees above the expected plate detection region, leaving you approximately 3 to 15 feet of vertical room to use. Position the camera so that it is no more than 15 degrees off the vehicle's center line in either direction. Mount the camera so that a horizontal line can be drawn that crosses both the left and right edges of the license plate. Position a vehicle or object in the center of the detection region and focus the camera. For applications where vehicles are free-flowing and not expected to come to a full or near stop, focus the camera on a point within the middle of the expected recognition area. Avoid positioning the camera in places with direct exposure to bright light sources, such as direct sunlight or in line with vehicle headlights, as this will negatively affect the exposure. Adjusting the camera's sunshade may help as well. If the installation has a low light level, below 500 lux, consider adding external infrared or white light sources to help provide illumination. But avoid positioning cameras or external light sources in a way that reflects light directly back at the camera sensor. The previously mentioned measurements should ensure that the plate letters and numbers are an appropriate size. Plate characters should be 25 to 60 pixels in height on the image sensor, with a stroke of 4 pixels or more to achieve the best results. On first use of the camera, you may choose to utilize exacqVision's Quick Add feature to speed setup or perform this manually. Quick Add is shown in detail in a separate video. First use without Quick Add will require choosing a security mode and setting login credentials, then connecting to the camera manually. The camera's user manual offers additional information on camera setup, while the exacqVision user manual and multiple support portal videos offer instructions on adding cameras to exacqVision. On the Picture Basic tab, use the Focus Zoom controls to adjust the zoom level and focus the image according to guidelines previously mentioned. Open the Events and Actions menu, then select Analytics, followed by the License Plate Recognition tab. Both the LPR and Object Classification analytics are enabled by default. The topmost checkbox enables or disables LPR detection. Checking the Highlight Detections box enables the display of bounding areas within the camera's web view. Note that AI object classification may be disabled on the camera without affecting the use of license plate recognition. The camera provides several pre-configured exposure profiles, which are preset combinations of exposure settings for a variety of common scenes. When configuring the camera settings, consider using one of the LPR exposure profiles prior to experimenting with custom configurations to save time during setup. Clear characters and numbers improve the camera's ability to correctly identify them. Three exposure profiles exist that are specific to LPR applications: LPR low, mid, and high. Each profile dictates the slowest possible shutter speed that the camera's auto exposure may select. The option you choose will depend on how fast the vehicles are moving. These modes utilize a constrained variable bitrate, allowing you to set a maximum bitrate up to 14,000, configure a maximum gain, and minimum exposure value. Auto exposure then selects the iris position, shutter speed, and gain as the light level changes. LPR profiles also adjust the camera's IR intensity to assist in low light. Because LPR low uses lower shutter speeds, it is best suited to stop and go applications, such as vehicles that pause for a parking garage entry gate. LPR mid and LPR high are better suited to applications where vehicles do not stop, but require more light to prevent blur at higher shutter speeds. Note that these cameras are not well suited to high-speed vehicle applications. Next, select the region, country, and issuing authority where needed. A list of supported countries is shown. Within the recognition configuration section is the ability to compose separate lists to be used for access control or notification purposes. These include allow and deny lists for access control, and two custom lists for you to use as you'd like. Selecting the edit icon beside each list provides the ability to adjust the recognition confidence level and draw a region of interest area, helping to exclude areas of the field of view you are uninterested in. For use cases where I/O trigger is needed directly from the camera rather than through exacqVision, use of the action field permits the triggering of the camera's relay outputs when configured with the event actions and alarm I/O pages. See camera documentation for further details. Editing the plates for each list is done using a CSV file. To edit or view the plates on each list, press the download button to access the correctly formatted CSV file. Edit the file with your preferred program, placing each plate on a new row. Spaces and plate IDs are ignored, but letters are case sensitive. List names are not case sensitive, but must match the list name in the camera. If editing the CSV file with a text editor, the plate number shall be followed by a comma and the name of the list to be added to. Though to make things easier, we recommend using Microsoft Excel to edit. In Excel, each row will contain the plate number in the first column, followed by the list name in the second column. Each list may be enabled or disabled individually. Up to 2,000 plate numbers may be stored. After your changes have been made, save the file. Use the Browse button to select your file, and then the Upload button to apply the changes to the camera. Plate recognition occurs whether or not access lists are used, but these lists provide the ability to trigger user-configured events and actions, either within the camera or through your exacqVision server. When connected to exacqVision, each LPR list is added as an analytic. This data is recorded similar to object classification analytics. Navigate to the camera settings page where the detection bounding box colors for each analytic may be customized individually, making them visually identifiable. So for example, you may highlight allow list plates in green and deny list plates in red. The camera provides exacqVision with an analytic for each of the lists: allow, deny, custom 1, and custom 2, as well as an overall plate detection analytic which will include all detected plates whether they exist on one of your lists or not. While in live viewing mode, you may right-click the video panel and select View Analytics to display bounding boxes. Forensic searches may be performed by selecting all or individual analytic streams. Display the analytic data by pressing the Show Hide Keywords and Serial Data button. Clicking a row within the keyword panel jumps the playhead to that point on the timeline below. Checking the Show Filters box opens the Keyword Analytic Filter panel. Selecting the Edit icon permits the ability to filter on specific plate numbers or issuing authorities. When applied, the search results are updated. exacqVision grants the ability to leverage LPR analytics as triggers for event linking and event monitoring actions as well. Event linking may be used to trigger access control integrations or I/O alarm outputs, if your exacqVision system has these. Event linking also provides the ability to send email notifications via SMTP if desired. Event monitoring may be used to change camera panels or entire views within the client, bringing attention to those monitoring for visitors coming and going. This video has covered best practices for LPR camera installation and its use with exacqVision. Refer to user manuals for additional information.